All right, Hunter. We're just talking round robin talk. Monroeville 3, that are all Americans this year. Who's the king of the ring?
Logan's king of the ring. He's the best.
Just stomps you guys still.
He just stomps us. He's really, really good. I mean, he's got big brother effect on me. I think he got a little bit on Cam's because, you know, we kind of always hold Logan to the higher standards because, you know, he's a Logie Bear.
Logie Bear. He's won a tournament today in Poland.
Yeah, he just won.
Is that his first international tournament win?
Yes.
Because he was silver in the junior, though, University Worlds, right?
Yeah, so his first international win over the Turkey guy, like number one Turkey guy to wait. It's crazy.
That's pretty good. When you look awesome. At that, and, you know, you've been, like I said, you and Roy Nelson. I don't know if you know who Roy Nelson is. He's the guy with a beer belly that fights UFC. I say you guys are the two toughest guys in the world. And I'm saying as in tough in the sense of able to take abuse. How can you take so much abuse? Why are you so tough?
I mean, just over the years through, like, I don't know, just kind of how I was raised, you know? I was raised to kind of, you know, I did something wrong, I got in trouble, and then I learned from it. I mean, I can't be a little girl about everything, you know? I mean, like, a lot of kids that get hurt, like, oh, I mean, just got to get back up. I mean, I was hurt all the time. I got hurt, and I walked off the mat crying, like a little kid. My dad was throwing back right back in there, like, get out there, you're not hurt. Kick him back, speak up, stop crying. Cry more time, do more push-ups.
So that's a learn, you think that's something just how you were raised?
Yeah. And I mean, Logan does have big brother effect on me, but I don't like getting embarrassed too well. So after a little while, he'd be beating up on me. I kind of try to get back at him, but maybe one takedown when he gets tired, not too many.
Do you take that as a compliment when I say something like that to you? Like you're the toughest guy in the sense of taking the most abuse?
Yeah, I definitely take it as a compliment. It's not like, oh, okay. No, but no, it's all. I mean, it's cool to think that, but.
What do you guys got to do, the Buckeyes? What do you got to do to win a national title? You guys have added some absolute studs in the high school ranks, signed some really good guys, and, you know, I think Chris might be coming in. All the four, Monroe, Fuller, will be back together. What do you guys got to do to win a national title?
We just got to, you know, work hard, you know, multiple practices a day, work hard, train hard, eat right, do the right things, like lifestyle. And I think we all do it. I mean, we all try to do it to the best of our ability. And, you know, every once in a while, you know, we have those cheat days where we eat pizza, stuff like that. But, I mean, we all want to win. We all saw what we did this year, and we all know what we can do. And, I mean, we want to win. We want to win a title as a team. We want to win individual titles. And, you know, we want to be like in high school when we were like Kings of Ohio. I mean, we want to be like, you know, also in the college too.
Kings of the country?
Kings of the country, there you go.
Okay, when you guys look at what they're going to do with you next year, will it be a redshirt year or will you wrestle?
I mean, it's going to come all down to the wrestle off. We have Ian Miller coming back, and, you know, he's a stud. We have Randy Lange still, and he's a stud. So, I mean, it's going to be.
Ian Miller? You just said Ian Miller.
Ian Paddock. I'm
Ian
sorry.
Paddock,
Ian
thank
Miller's
you.
Ian Miller's been here at the camp.
He's walking around and behind us right now.
Yeah, that's why I saw him. So, okay. But Ian Paddock, yeah, Ian Paddock's a stud. Ian Miller's a stud too. But Ian Paddock, he's a stud. He's really
so
good.
It'll come down to what Paddock is 41, the wrestler.
Yeah, Paddock will probably be 41. He's 41 or 49, but I mean, he's not very big. But so it'll be Paddock, me, Paddock, and Langus. Langus is a stud too. He beat some pretty good kids out at the university, so he's pretty good.
Do you see yourself continue to climb weight classes?
I don't know. I mean, I lost weight since my freshman year, but I mean, I got a little bit bigger, I guess, but I lost weight. I don't know, it's weird. I got a lot leaner, I guess. But I mean, I could probably end up being like a 57 or 65 if I put enough muscle on. But I don't think I will.
So it could be, you could be a life 41, you could be a 49, 57, 65.
Yeah, it could be a life 41 until Logan decides to go 41 and stomps me.
You give him a lot of credit.
He's really good. He trains, he's the hardest trainer in the whole like RTC. We have a lot of good guys in the RTC, and they train super extremely hard. And Logan is up there, like top tier, like top like 2-3 guys who train so hard. Every morning he's in there running. Afternoon, he doesn't just go to the practices. He goes there and he works his hardest there. It's crazy. I'm glad I have him there because I want to be like him. I try to do my best to be like him.
All right, what'd you learn from the NCAA tournament this year? Whether it be, you know, how Cam fought back through the Conso bracket, how Heflin finished, how Logan, you know, upset Oliver, losing the semifinals and taking sixth, you know, like dropping three matches in a row. That's something I don't know if you've ever done that.
No, I haven't.
What do you think you really like learned? Did you learn most from Logan? What did you learn the most from it?
I think I learned the most from Logan just because he. I mean, a lot of things like wrestling, like Logan's really good, but a lot of his biggest enemies is like the weight cut. And he cut weight perfectly at the NCAA tournament. He was like 7 pounds over for like after like semis and cut it all in like an hour. He just, you know, he was so happy after he won. He didn't care about his weight. He ate good, felt good, and just went out there and wrestled. I think I learned that, I mean, not to keep my weight down too much and just, you know, Logan, he doesn't get nervous. I don't really get nervous too much, but he just doesn't get nervous. He knows he's been training so hard that he's gonna win. And I think everyone should have that mindset. And if you get that mindset, I mean, you'll be good.
Your dad played basketball. He was on the state championship basketball team. Yeah. How do you guys learn so much about mentalities and just how to train and, you know, like everything, how he raised you? Like, how did a basketball guy raise two freak wrestlers?
I don't know. He just kind of asked us what we wanted to do, and Logan's like, I want to be a champion. So he's like, well, you want to do wrestling? He goes, yeah. Well, you're going to work really hard at wrestling to be a champion then. So, I mean, we just kind of picked the sport and went with it. And everyone does, you know, everyone does bitty wrestling, even if they ended up playing basketball. Everyone does bitty wrestling, like, in our community. So we kind of just did bitty wrestling, and we were a little shorter and smaller than normal kids, so we just kind of, little Mighty Mouses over there scrapping. So we kind of just went with it, and we liked it a lot, and we improved, had great coaches, and then I just ended up where we ended up.
All right, what's next? Summer school?
Oh, yeah, I have summer school. I have an online class. I'm doing some camps, wrestling out, trying to get better. Definitely training for next year.
How important is trying really hard? I think that's the biggest thing I've gotten out of your dad, is he just wants you guys to try real hard.
Yeah, I mean as long as you like try super hard. And when we were little, he's like, I mean, I don't care if you, like, we always got upset if you lost. He goes, I don't care if you lose. Is this, if you tried hard and you lost, I'm okay with it. But if you didn't try hard and lost, I mean, I'm gonna get mad at you. I mean, if you guys train harder. So I mean, that's kind of the thing. It's kind of try your hardest. If you try your hardest and you lose, I mean, you just gotta improve on that. But if you don't try hard at all and you lose, that sucks.
It's unacceptable to him?
Yeah, it's unacceptable.
All right, you got anything else for me?
No.
All right, I'll let you off the hook and close the gap on your brother, okay? And whenever you figure out what weight you're going next year, let me know, all right?
All right.